everyone. So today I wanted to do a review of the new Kylie Cosmetics blushes. I did get two of them, so I just wanted to kind of show you the ones that I have, talk about what type of product they are, and yeah, this should be a fairly quick video. So the two that I have are X-Rated and Barely Legal. X-Rated is like the peachy nude looking one, and Barely Legal is just like a pretty light pink color. They look like this. They have a little mirror and a compact mirror, and they're just like, you know, the same type of material as her palettes. They're not like a harder, more sturdier packaging. The packaging is still cute though. It's not ugly. It's just not as sturdy as like NARS or something like that. The price of these was $20 each, so it was $40 total, and I don't know if there was like some special going on when I bought them, but I didn't have to pay shipping, which was really nice. For me, $20 isn't too much to spend on a blush. I feel like anywhere from like 15 to maybe like 23 is probably in my price range, because I'm used to getting stuff at Sephora rather than the drugstore, so I thought this wasn't too much of, you know, a ripoff or anything like that. But I did have a feeling that these blushes were not going to be good. I had a feeling they were going to be chalky. I just kind of could tell by looking at them. Same thing with some of her eyeshadows in the Valentine's Day palette. I do have one of the palettes, the Burgundy palette, and I think that's great. The eyeshadows are fine. I don't have a problem with the quality of those. These I do. As I suspected, they're really chalky. You know, if you ever watch like swatches of people, videos of people doing swatches, and they go like this and they put it on their arm and it's like so pigmented. I feel like they're like digging, like how I'm just digging right now. Like I'm digging and it's still just like not really, I don't know, that much. And if you go to put it on the hand, it's just like, it's kind of just like chalk. Like it's really, like I'm really like ruining it right now. And to try to get that on my hand, it's just a very, very sheer. Same thing with this one. It's just kind of chalky. Again, I'm like really digging here. And then, you know, from the back of my hand, it's just nothing is really showing up. And I really don't know how I could tell. Like I just can tell sometimes with watching those videos of people doing swatches, like if they're really like kind of faking it. My hand isn't like extra dry or anything. It doesn't have, you know, moisturizer all over it, but it's certainly not, there's no reason that the product shouldn't be sticking to my hand. I do have on right now Barely Legal, the pink one, which, you know, I had to kind of do a few coats. Regardless of them being not that pigmented, they are blushes, they're not eyeshadows, so they don't really need to be like so pigmented, because nobody's putting on like a thick pigmented layer of blush. It's just not happening. And another thing that I noticed was the smell. Right away, it just has that like chemically, like plasticky, just chemically type of smell to it. I don't think it's the packaging, because when it's closed, I can't smell it, but when it's open, I smell it and it smells like gross. It smells like chemicals. I don't know how else to describe it. Let me know if you have these and you found that same thing. So unfortunately, I don't love these. I'll keep using them because I freaking bought them. I'm not going to return these. They were 40 bucks total. It's just like a waste of my time to even bother doing that. I'll still wear them because, like I said, they're blushes and they don't have to be super pigmented for me to, you know, use it. It's not an eyeshadow where you want like the absolute best color payoff, but I really am kind of turned off by that smell, the chemical smell. I think packaging's cute, and the colors, these two colors are nice, and it's nice that she came out with like deeper colors for other skin tones. But yeah, I don't know, I'm not really feeling them. There's no shimmer in them. They're all matte. I do prefer like a little bit of shimmer in my blush. I guess it depends on how I'm feeling, but I feel like with people that make videos about the Kylie Cosmetics products, they're either kissing her ass or they're like totally dissing her and saying either, you know, I love this, this is the best product ever, because maybe they were sent it or they want to get sent stuff from her PR team or whatever, or they're dissing it because they just hate the Kardashians and they just want to, you know, hate everything and get attention on the video, on their video or whatever. That is not the case for me. I love the Kardashians. I love Kylie, but I just don't love these blushes. I do like her liquid lipsticks, the ones that I have, and her eyeshadow palette. But hey, that's, you know, the case for me with most brands. Like Lancome, you know, if you're a subscriber of mine, I die for their foundation. I'm obsessed with it. I think their eyeshadows are chalk. At least the ones that I've used. So, you know, you're not always gonna die for every product in, you know, a brand. So, don't really love these, but again, you may see me using them just because I have them. So that is all I have for you guys today. I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye, guys.